Hello Facebook Ads people, I'm Konstantinos and today we're going to analyze how you can run ads to different countries because a lot of times people use the same ad accounts but I don't think that this is actually correct. So, whatever we're going to discuss here is going to be for massive accounts. If you have a small account and you want to test different countries, it's fine. So, I'm going to show you actual results so that you can see that all that I'm going to actually say here on a technical level, they actually work and they do make sense. So I'm going to show you one big company that I have scaled, which I started on August up to now making them millions. Let's discuss a little bit about why in a technical level this is correct. If you have a small ad account and you have a small spend, it doesn't matter. But we know that in ad accounts, when you have big spends, it actually takes a toll to your campaigns when you are scaling. What I'm trying to say with this is that ad accounts are not meant to scale as much as you want because they also have a behavior. If you're spending a lot of money in one ad account, most probably this is going to limit you from the actual amount that you can spend. Does this mean that if you run ads for United States, you have to use multiple ad accounts? This is something that was tested extensively. I can tell you that in several cases, it's also working. I can tell you in other cases, it didn't produce any other results. I can tell you that the main ad account that you have, it's always going to be the best and produce the best results because it's a more trained ad account. We discussed in this channel that the ad accounts are also getting trained to certain behaviors. So, based on that, I have started realizing, and of course, this is not something that I have found on my own. This is something that people do since I don't know when. The point here is this. Why is it good to have different pixels and different domains and different everything for the different countries? It is good because the demographics are different. The people that are going to be interested in one product in Europe are completely different in terms of demographics from the people that they are going to be interested in Australia and in the United States. Why? Because the life is different. For example, just a very stupid example, the average age of mothers in Europe, maybe it's completely different from the one on United States or Australia. The obesity levels of people in United States and in Europe, it's different. The behavior of people of how they go to work and when they go back and everything, it's different. For example, just a stupid example, okay? Let's think of it. The people that they go to work in United States, they go and they park to their big house after they go to home. In our countries in Europe, I can tell you that you need, after you go to 9-to-5 work, you will be home at 6 o'clock because you need 1 hour to find parking because everybody is trying to park and we live inside the cities, which is completely different from other countries that they have a lot of space like Australia or United States. So, or Canada, there are so many different things that we have to think over here, which leads us to, and of course, let's not talk about Europe, which is super fragmented with so many different languages and so on. So imagine having one ad account with all of these problems and being able to train it like this. You would need a master pixel that it would be a pixel that you could sell anything after all. So in order for us to have actually viable targets, we are having different pixels to different demographics, to different countries. Another very big problem is the time zone. You cannot run ads at 6 a.m. in United Kingdom, at 6 a.m. in USA, because they're going to reset at a different point. Because the ad account has 1 hour. It doesn't have different hours. So if you are set for New York time, the ads are going to reset at 12 o'clock. Fine for all of your United States ads. But what is it going to happen with the ads that you run for United Kingdom? They're going to reset much earlier and most probably during your prime time. So this is a huge problem, and this is something that I was observing all the time, especially the reset hour of the ads, because it wasn't helping on the optimization. When are you going to optimize them, after all? Based on that, my categorization is mostly about the time zone. So what I would do is that, let's say that we have a worldwide brand. I would do another account for United States and Canada. You can have them both together, they have similar demographics. I would do another one for Australia, New Zealand, and maybe you have people in Singapore or whatever that you want to target in this area, okay? And then we have another one massive that you can have for United Kingdom. I would put it alone as United Kingdom, and then one for Europe that you can test different languages and whatever. I wouldn't try to segment it to France, Germany and stuff. I have seen it working as a whole because the countries are smaller. Germany is a very good market, by the way. I have seen very good results with English and with German text. The main reason is the different demographics, but for me, the crucial factor over here is the time zone and when the ads are going to reset. Of course, you can also group United Kingdom with other countries, but I find United Kingdom a huge market, and I think that it really works if you train a pixel just for the United Kingdom audience. The structure is this. You're having a main domain and you're having subdomains below that, which is going to be the different subdomains for the different countries that you want to target, especially if you want to use different languages, is going to help you a lot. And of course, you have different pixels for these subdomains. You're having a pixel for UK, you're having a pixel for United States. That means that you're having pixels that are actually going to be trained for each country. And now that we have mentioned all of that in a technical level and we have analyzed why you should do this or that, let's go to my computer so that I can show you how this specific tactic actually worked for one of my clients, separating all the other accounts. By the way, they were using only one ad account, so I told them that we have to do this. Of course, it was a successful brand, but they were having one pixel, many problems. Also, let me tell you that, for example, if you operate in a massive scale like this, you're going to have most probably different storage houses in United Kingdom, in Australia, in United States. If something happens to United States, it's extremely difficult for you to manage one account for this problem that you have in stock, for example, in United States. And what are you going to do? Lower the budgets over there for United States, and then it doesn't make any sense. But if you have a problem in United Kingdom, you just go and you just slow down the account of the United Kingdom. If you have a problem in another area, you can do that too. There are a lot of companies that they make pixels and ad accounts based on the logistics that they have and how they're going to send products, which makes total sense to me. It makes total sense because if you see that you have very good stock or a very good offer that you can give for United Kingdom, like free shipping, you have a different offer. On the other hand, if you have one site, you need to have a massive offer for everywhere, and maybe it's not going to work on the same way as it was going to work. For example, for this company in Black Friday, we had free shipping for United Kingdom, but we had another better offer for United States because the logistics made sense. And of course, you can have different offers on how you can send them, and so on and so on and so on. So let me show you how I scaled these two ad accounts. One was in UK, one was in the United States. We talked about why we need to separate them, but let's see what happened here. So from the 1st of August to the 10th of January that I'm actually doing this video, I've spent 134K pounds and I generated 1.4 million in United Kingdom. Most of the times, the United Kingdom accounts are just the little brother of the United States. And the reason that we separate them, as we said, is because of the demographics being different and everything, and we want to have different pixels with that so that we can be more accurate. Now, if your spending is very small, I don't think that you should do this. But if you want to grow big, like we do in this campaign, you should have them separately. Over here, as you can see, most probably you cannot see because my editors are going to hide everything over here so that I'm going to protect the client. We are having a mix of Crazy Method, Advantage Plus campaigns, and this is a big difference over here. Manual bidding. Manual bidding is working very well on United Kingdom in a lot of ad accounts. You should test it. Of course, you need to have the technical background, but I hope that with my videos it's going to help you understand how you can do it. If you want to go deeply to manual bidding, you should go and take the course. The other thing that I want to mention here is that, of course, we can see that with lower spend, we are having better ROAS compared to what we are having in the United States account. Because in the United States account, I was able to spend more, 424K, 3.3 million. The difference here is this. If you put in the same ad account, the USA and the United Kingdom, most probably you're going to push the whole limit of the ad account in the way that it's spending, and you won't be able to actually scale in the same way, because always the UK accounts are going to be underserved compared to the USA accounts. Have I done it in one account? Yes, a lot of times I have done it. And I have seen that it's not working as efficiently as when you separate the two accounts. In smaller spends, it doesn't matter. But here, as you can see, in this kind of spends that we are having, it's completely different, and you should actually look at it very closely. And of course, the way that you see here, of course, you can see we have one base campaign and then we use our methods, all of our methods, whatever I'm teaching you this channel is being applied here. Crazy Method, stacked lookalikes, doing Advantage Plus campaigns, a new method that we have with scaling by duplicating and removing that that has worked before. Doing manual bidding not in the United States but in the United Kingdom. The high society method, crazy methods, interests, whatever we can do, we're scaling, maintaining of course a very good profitability in that case for the client because he's working with higher ROAS. And as you can see, we're having our base campaigns. This one has spent 155K. It's a very big percentage. It's one of the campaigns that is working very well. Why? We were fortunate enough having a good creative or whatever, and this is our base campaign. And then we have another base campaign over here. Those were closed because most probably in the last 7 days they didn't work, but still we were profitable. Because the point over here, especially with big budgets, is not to get carried away. When something is not working as a trend in the last 7 days, you close it so that you can maintain the profitability. You're not going to be able to have 7.7 ROAS with 4.24K spent if you just leave your ads for a very long period. These are ad accounts that they need a lot of attention. I'm not going to call myself a no-lifer because I really enjoy what I do, but I work, guys, 24/7. I work even on weekends. I work always on my vacation. I haven't taken a full day off for the past 4 or 5 years because the spend doesn't stop. You cannot just stop spending just because Costadinos wants to go on vacation. These are businesses, so you need to respect the money that they actually spend. And this is how it goes, and this is why I have this kind of good cooperations, because I'm very consistent. The same thing that I'm saying to each one of my videos, the same thing I do with the ad accounts, and I'm being very consistent with that. So that's all I had about how you should run a very big scale business in the United States and United Kingdom. This also applies if you want to go to to Australia and stuff, and you have to do another ad account in there. So good for them, good for me. As you can see, it worked very well. I hope that it's going to inspire you, and if you're not doing it, you're going to go through the trouble, because it is a trouble to actually have this kind of structure, and it's more work, I understand it, but it's technically correct and this is what you should do. Don't forget that if you want to learn more, you can check my book or my free course. You can go also check my site, and until we meet again, be creative and be consistent.